So, hello guys. Just preparing everything so I can start to play. Is the sound okay? Because some people complain to me that sound on videos is not so good. Okay, let's start to play. Yesterday I really didn't be so much focused. I need to correct some small things. But these are only small things. So this is current situation. 5 games I played, 4 wins. Not so bad. Not so bad. How is my schedule? I think you went to snow. Udinese at home, then you went to Savoy. Okay. Yesterday I forgot to save this one as version 2, and also I need to put it in this slot. Okay, also in this one. So this is one of the small things what I forgetted. All other, I was thinking even maybe to try to sell some of players. For example, this guy, the price is still good, but the problem is I have decided to wait. I think I will play first half season with this current squad, even if there is still some opportunity. Never mind. We will continue with the fucking games and we will see how this works. So, Udinese 4-4-2. Interesting. Is this my best lineup? I think I already put yes. Budimir Casano, Muriel. Very important game because next game is Juventus away. So with Juventus, with Dybala and other players, I think I will struggle against them. So I need to win this game. Udinese is one of my favorite clubs from Serie A. I mean, a lot of times I was managing them. Some problem is the with fucking picture. Wait a moment. Need to adjust something. Okay. If you have problem with picture quality, just tell me in the Twitch chat. For me, it's okay. This is one of the issues what I'm having on Twitch. Sometimes very clever pass, but Zapata is basically target man. So can Cassano do some good pass? Decent shot, I must say, very decent, but goalkeeper saved it. The thing what I like with Sampdoria, my two fullbacks are basically central defenders. By the height, I mean. I like to have tall fullbacks. Luckily for me, he missed again. Okay, so Budimir started to scoring. Very nice. I think he will be even better if he managed to train this shoot with power. So I have two players with yellow cards, so for sure I will replace left fullback. Regarding the Muriel, maybe not immediately, because he is striker. This needs to be a goal. It was really poor cross. Regarding my squad, I was watching the videos what I uploaded yesterday with some games. Yeah, you can see really that I having lack of quality of in the team, but tactic is working very, very good. So that's the main issue why I'm having good results. Can Cassano score? No. So when you play with, when are you playing with back four players? I always like to buy fullbacks who are very good defensively. If they do some offensively more or less, but they need to have high tackling, work rate, let's say decent speed. And I like that if possible to find some taller guys. So. Like always, immediately I will replace the guy with yellow card. Regarding Muriel, I will also replace him. I will put Ricky there. This happens when you're having full back with poor dribbling skills. Cassano is also not playing quite well in this fucking game. So two substitutions are already done. Probably I will replace one of the midfielders. But not now, later on. I will keep Cassano in. This was really perfect chance for cross, but Dodo decided to pass the ball. It was, I think, better option if he crossed the ball. Because I'm having Budimir fucking. Cassano, dribble there, fight. Some kind of combination of goalkeeper save it and ball also touch, I think, post. I need second goal. As you can see, very good technical skills of my midfielders, very good passing. And that's 2-0. Bruno Fernandes was one of my favorite players before, I mean, in previous FM, just because of his scoring. I mean, technical attributes with very good scoring abilities. That was before, I don't know. Now it's still, I think, okay, but not so good. I'm having that one young midfielder on the bench with good potential, I think. Offside. I will use substitution. Maybe it's even better to wait for last 10 minutes just to close the game, but I want to give him chance to play this Torreira. And I will remove Cigarini. Yeah, some people ask me regarding the skin. It's OPSZ Elite skin. You can download it. There is on the FM Scout forum. You can find it. It's OPSZ Elite and it's Thai version or something like that. The guys who are done it are from Thailand or something. So next game is against Juventus. If I manage to do not lose the game, it will be really good. I will change now to defensive. As you can see, maybe it was a better option that I waited with that substitution. Because now there is still 4-5 minutes. I hate when central defender is... If you kick the ball, fuck it, kick it 50 meters from the goal. This is dangerous. So Zapata is like target man. I was really afraid. Vladimir, pass on the other side. Okay, so Torreira, my substitution, scored the goal. Very good counter attack. Budimir used his physical attributes to win the duel and just easy pass. Very easy win for my side, I must say. The problem is this guy is left footed, and if Muriel cannot play here, I can use it on this side. No. Okay. I decided that I will put him on the transfer list. I will try to sell it because he's worth 6.5 million. Very simple, I having this fucking Juricic here, so it will be good if possible to make some money. Even I'm not planning to buy for now nobody. You see. I forget to ask from the board. So as you can see, I don't always same answer that club will be behind our rivals, so they approved. So 90% still okay. We will see. Yes, mate, I won with Sunderland, I also won with Hull. You can check on my YouTube channel. Entire career of the Sunderland is on YouTube. But I think I done great success also with Hull 2 months ago when I played. So I won Premiership in the first season, and in second season I won everything except Premiership. So I won the Champions League with Hull in the second season. Plus FA, all the cups I won. So I lost the Premiership, I mean I finished second, but I was having a lot of points in that season. You can check for more info on FM Base, that is my topic there. Sunderland is like, I mean, I built a team defensively, and I was hoping that Defoe will perform as poacher and score the goals. That had been some kind of plan. I am hoping now that Dybala will not play. He's fucking insane in FM. I don't know. I still feel that a lot of players are overpowered in this game. For example, Pogba, Dybala, and a lot of English players. Like Johnny Evans. I will not pay even half million for that guy. And he's how many? 16 million worth. So Pjanic will not play. That's also a good thing because of his set pieces. This Mihajlović is piece of shit. So Lazio Napoli, let's hope they will draw. So both of them lose 2 points. Now Lazio won, fuck it. They also defeated me. I'm having now problem because the Silvestre is suspended. So I need to use this guy. Or maybe I will use... No. Concentration is shit. Problem, Dodo is not strong defensively. And I want to have tall fullbacks in this game. I will risk and I will put this guy as central defender. Maybe not good idea, but I still feel that is better solution. Barreto is ready to play very good, so... Let's hope. Not so bad for now, really not so bad. So I'm hoping that I will not lose the game. So they are playing 3-5-2, standard. This will be a very tough game just because they have two strikers and... Let's say if I'm having better quality players in this game, probably I will change formation to 3-5-2. If I have higher quality players for this game. Especially 4-3-3 is very, very attacking. Nah, this is went very bad. So first attack they scored the goal, so probably I'm fucked in this game. poor reaction from my central defenders. They needed to clear this game. Can he cross? As you can see, I'm still attacking and Juventus will counter me because the Dybala off-ball movement is really, really good. Also, I didn't have the luck. I mean, from first chance they scored the goal. That is always bad. Tackle him, fuck it. Okay, this is what I'm telling you. Every pass in the space will be a nightmare for my team. Yeah, I think it was better idea that I play with 3 at back in this game. Now I will have a very big defeat. Defense is leaking everywhere. But we all know that titles are always won in the small games. So now it's fucking penalty. This will be catastrophic in this fucking game. Yeah, not going quite well. But never mind, let's hope I will defeat the smaller teams and keep the pressure. But this will fuck my goal difference. Yeah, I needed to play with 3 at back in this fucking game. That is my mistake. I needed to change to on Pirate Poacher tactic and remove Kassan also. Play with Muriel and Budimir. I will try that to do in the second half. Let's see how this... I cannot do that one in the second half. I am lacking... I need to see how many central defenders I am having on the bench. Can I score some goal, fact? So... Okay. So I will change now formation in the second half. I mean, this I needed to do before. I think I needed to play from beginning like this one, but he's not natural as central defender, fuck. Never mind, going like this. Alo Dumi Kata. Also rating of my players in this game was so bad. But as I said, I need to defeat another teams in division. Like Genoa, Udine in this one. And what is good for now, I still didn't play any draw the game. I'm winning or losing. So, this will be my second defeat. So, the people who are don't know, this is the tactic what I use with Sunderland. Pirate Poacher is the name. So for now in second half looking decent, Juventus didn't have any chances to fuck me. Almost go, almost! Again, poor defending. Poor defending. Now, this is also somebody asked the question why I'm never looking the match stats of the opponents. I don't care for opponents. If let's say my left back is having 5.4, immediately I know that there on that side is some player with his same rating. Basically I don't care for performance of another team. I only look my team and that's it. I think I will do team meeting after this game. I don't know, we will see. I don't know how much, need to see how much morale will drop after it. I mean, this is, I'm underdog in this game and it's away game. So, I'm hoping not so much. So if I play from beginning with 3 at back, I think result will be much better for me. So next game will be really important. I need to win, I need to keep the pace with this. See this guy, what I was having dubbed really poor performance. So I am now 3 points behind of Juventus. How is my schedule next? So Fiorentina home, Crotone away, Pescara home, Atalanta, Inter. I think if I can defeat Fiorentina, this can be maybe very good run. See, I'm playing at Inter home, Roma home, Torino home also. interesting. Morale is still good, I will not do team meeting. Maybe I will do some fuck up and then will drop. So 2 weeks until next game. Now what you want? So another problem. Okay, everything is on me, that's... So looks like I will manage to sell this Ricky Alvarez. You see, all Juventus fucking players by average rating. I really boosted them. Oh, Fiorentina is almost on the bottom, so their morale is very low for sure. So this is a very good opportunity for my team. Especially I'm playing very attacking. Very attacking approach is always good against teams who has poor morale. Every year is the same. So let's hope I will manage to score early goal and destroy Fiorentina. Even they have quality for, let's say, top 5. I don't care for these scout assignments. So guys, what you're thinking about my Sampdoria team? I mean, it's basically default squad. I'm hoping that Cassano will do some good performance in the next game. From him, I just need his passing ability, that's it. Some assists. maybe if this club didn't already sign two players outside from European Union, maybe I would buy some players. But the squad, Sampdoria is having big squad, so I can survive for now. Yeah, this skin is really nice. The latest update is really good. Sassuolo Juventus. So let's hope that Juventus will lose, drop some points. No chance. So Fiorentina is having fucking Bernardeschi and Kalinic, so are they playing? Yes. The problem with Fiorentina is always they don't have strong defensive midfielders, and also their fullbacks are shit. They have some decent quality up front. Okay, so this is my standard lineup. Nothing special there. Do not give him card immediately, fuck. No, okay, very good. So as I said, against team who are in poor run, I need early goal. Yeah, this will be much better if I having, let's say, on false nine, two explosive players who can dribble. This is maybe a red card. Fuck! Shit. Now I'm in big problem. Maybe I'll lose this game. Probably I will lose now this game. So I decided to remove Cassano because no any use of him. He now have pace to. Give him fucking yellow card for this shit. very poor defending. The right full back, I don't know where he was. He was nowhere. So looks like I will lose this game. I hate when I receiving red card for nothing. This is also bugging this fucking game. Every 3-4 game I'm having that situation. I don't know why. I think they need to reduce percentage of that shit. Can you score? Ah! I can't believe that he didn't score this one. I will be happy with point, just that I don't lose. Even with one player less, I'm playing quite nice. I mean, I'm having 70% of possession with one player less. Give me some penalty or some shit. Can't fucking believe it. I lose the game because of fucking red card. Can they receive? Can this fucking ball receive a second yellow? Pah! No luck, no luck in this game. Give him fucking second yellow card. Now I'll receive the red card. One more, probably. Fucking shit! This Salah is very bad in defensive phase. Sometimes I really hate this game. Tackle him immediately there, fuck it. Oh my god. 72% of possession I'm having with one player less entire first half. Ayoy. What I will do now? I need to replace this idiot or I'm risking one more. I'm going with Barreto there. I need to risk. He has good work rate. I hope he can cover this one. I'm not having another option. No. I'll try this option. Maybe it's a little bit better. But Dodo is also very poor defensively, fuck. And he is against Bernadeschi, this will be fucked up also. Not so optimistic. Pass him, fuck it. What fucking booking, piece of shit. You see, 72% fucking possession. One player less entire game. If I'm having really good players, I will destroy this division with this tactic. Give him fucking second yellow. I will not go attacking. Can you score? Fuck it. Ah. Now fucking goalkeeper saving or what? Or was the bar? Something like that. Give him. This is one more card. Fuck. I'm going attacking now. Now I'm having one player more. And I score immediately. A very weird game. Where is fucking Budimir? Pass him left there. Oh my god. But he hit my player, fuck it. What the fuck is this? Take the ball. Where is this youngster who scored the last game, this guy? Fucking mobile phone, I need to cut all this sound, piece of shit. So I'm now hoping that this youngster will give me some clever pass in last 25 minutes. Give me penalty referee, fuck, I want also. Fucking Barreto, I just replaced him now, fuck. So I was losing 1-0 and Fiorentina was having penalty and one player more. And now I'm having one. Will I go attacking? No, I will change back to control. I want to keep to slow the pace. Okay, one more goal. I think I'm a little bit lagging. What the fuck is this? I was really thinking that I will lose this fucking game, but looks like... But... You saw everything in the first half. I mean, one player less and I'm having 72-73% of possession. Against Fiorentina, who is, let's say, good team. Imagine if I'm having high quality players, what I will do in this fucking division. That's why I never play with stronger teams. No any challenge there. If you create good tactic and some good management, you can always be top 4, top 5. Even with worst team. Bruno Fernandes is having the card. How many substitutions I have done? Already all. Who was this fucking Budimir again? Missed clear chance. That's second clear chance for him. He missed. So I'm back 3 points behind Juventus. And I'm having now decent schedule, really decent. Yeah, I must say this was one of the really interesting the games. I think Budimir will shoot penalty because I put, I think, Cassano as first option, Budimir is second. A good he fuck missed two clear chances. I don't know why he is not playing this season. I mean, in reality, in Sampdoria. I mean, why you bought him if he don't play? I'm in the first season, guys. Fuck it. I just started. This is how many games? I play only 8 games, you see? I only signed Golden Eagle as central defender. I don't need nobody. I mean, I need only top players. I don't need bullshit. Very, very, I must say, interesting game. I mean, 68% possession. Not so bad. So Crotone, Sampdoria. Only 3 points I'm expecting there. Where is fucking Juventus? This is my transfers, guys. You see? A start is okay because yesterday, whoever watched on Twitch, I was really, a few times I was testing how to fit fucking Cassano, that was the issue. And then I tried this formation, this is my tactic what I was using, and it's working quite good. I mean, Cassano is performing decently. But I done mistake against Juventus, I must say. I needed to play with 3 at back because when they're using Higuan and Dybala, I needed to play with 3 at back. But I'm, as I said, I'm not so focused in this fucking game. I mean, as you can see, I'm not even checking who are my coaches and everything, all this shit. I just want to play the games. We will see in January transfer window whatever, whoever is very good potential player, I will try to buy because I will not go by position, I don't think so. I mean, I need everybody. Sampdoria squad need completely change. Maybe only I can keep maybe goalkeeper. It's decent for Italian league, but all other Budimir can be also decent bench option. But so this guy is suspended. I need to use this fucking, what is the name? This Salah. Very poor defensively. Yeah, I know. All my tactics, as you can see, this one is the tactic what I use with Watford, 4-3-3 attractive. Only I change because I'm not having complete forward, I use deep lying forward. It's basically same role, so all the tactic what I created at start of the game, I mean even in the beta. So this tactic is created in the beta, it's still fantastic. So I'm always trying, you know, before I publish tactic, I always play, I am playing it and testing. I mean, if people fail, it's not my problem. Probably they don't know how to play. You can see, I know a lot of players and when I see how they playing FM, this is fucking disaster. Maybe if I can sign in January one extra striker, I mean one false nine, and use it instead of Cassano, but that will be not story. I want to keep Cassano as starter. Some guy who is, let's say, a very good dribbler with good finishing and long shot, who can score the goals from outside. Then I will have good chance to be in the top. So counter-attacking by Crotone. Again, I started very badly. I mean, complete forward is for me the best role, but it's hard to find this type of the player. But if you don't have, you can always use deep lying forward support. Any striker in the world can play that role. Even the target men like Budimir. I think when I was playing last time the Italian League, I think I lost the both games against Crotone. I think that was with Atalanta, and they being relegated, and I lost both games. I think it was Crotone. I don't know where is Cassano. Cassano was playing first two games good, now he's nowhere. Cassano, why are you fucking returning ball back? Can you score? Offside. Pass. Can I equalize before fucking half time? Barreta is having card, I need to replace him. I'll put that youngster again in. Now I picked this club just because of Cassano. I wanted to play with him in the first 11. That's the thing with this Sampdoria. That's why I picked them. They are not they don't have squad what I really like, the type of squad. But because of Kassan, I wanted, let's say, to have one older guy to play. Same like if you play with Roma, fuck. If I play Roma, I will just play because of Totti. I don't want to play with Roma and keep Totti on the bench. That's fucking bullshit, my opinion. The legends need always to play in the squad until they retire. Hey, little bitch, come on. Could you see what is my problem? I cannot score. I need player who can make the difference. All my three strikers, they are not top. They cannot do nothing individually. Almost fucking goal from the cross. What the fuck is with goalkeeper? I will give chance to Pride. Djuric is nothing. Yeah, I bought last year the new, I mean, in May, Mercedes I bought. That's why I'm not at home 6-7 months in the year. That's why I cannot fucking stream all day. Because of fucking job. Because I'm working outside of Croatia, so... So I sacrificed. But I'm having good money. I you see this apartment I bought. Apartment I bought Mercedes living alone. I'm afraid to go attacking in this fucking game because it's a away game and I think this Crotone maybe will counter-attack me. Regarding the substitution, I'm not having so good option. Look this for now. I'm not having a good striker option on the bench. Where is this fucking Quagliarella? I think he's injured fucking for 5 months. I'm having this guy. I'm going attacking now. I will not replace nobody, but it's not wise decision this one. What the fuck now? I need to replace him. Bruno Fernandes is my best player, I mean, what I'm seeing. If I replace him, can you take the ball? This game is not going quite well. I see you are chatting a lot on the Twitch. How will I win this fucking game now? Where is this? I can't risk fucking second yellow card. You see the Djuricic morale, I can't even put him. I can put this guy instead of Budimir. Fuck, 6.2 rating for the striker. Okay. So this guy, what I brought in. I will just pause the game. I also notice if you score goal on attacking, let's say, I need to return back on the control. And this I notice in a lot of games. If I stick with this same offensive approach, what I change, I will concede the goal. This is what I'm fucking telling. I needed to replace this immediately. This is again mistake by me. I needed to replace this immediately. When I scored the goal, I needed to return back to control. Now I'm going again fucking attacking. As you can see, bad move by me. This is when you are not fully focused, some shit happens. Give me a fucking penalty or some shit. Where is this target man? Ah, another guy who I brought in score. Okay. So immediately I'm now putting back fucking to control. So two both guys, two youngsters, they score the goals. So this is also some youngster target man, I don't know. They brought him on the start of the season. Kasan! I'll just pause the game, I want to see. What are you writing on this chat? But there is one guy on FM base, what he posed, that he didn't lose, I think, 60-70 games with reading. And he played, I think, 4-3-3, this tactic. In three seasons, he didn't lose any fucking game. He won everything with reading. I mean, even cup games, all these official games. I think you can find that on my topic. I never use wingers, I don't like tactics with wingers. Even in real football, I don't like. Shoot! So you can see in the midfield, I'm having some. Fuck. I also forget to change the defensive last 10 minutes. So when you are here now, you are watching this one. What false nine will fit in Sampdoria? What do you think? Normally, I don't use false nines. So what do you think I need to go in, let's say, in January transfer window? Maybe Cookie from Malaga. I don't know how he's in this update. He's left-footed and he can play false nine on the left side, where I'm now using Muriel. And he can score the goals. I don't know how much is his price. Maybe I can even buy it now immediately. Because I'm having now some money. there is that guy from Real Madrid that I think from he's from South America, but he just joined Real Madrid. He has insane stats. I think he's also like false nine. Or he's from Paraguay or Chile, something like that. So as you can see, these fucking smaller games are most important thing. You need to always win these small games. So I won again. And two guys from the bench, they make instant impact. Yeah, I think this Cigarini I need to sell on the January transfer window. I have a lot of midfielders. So, what are you thinking about this game? Now Pescara is coming. So not so bad. Even my strikers are... let's say not high class. So any suggestion what player to bring in January transfer window? What the fuck? Oh. What I wanted to write? This one I was thinking. I never have him, but to bring this one maybe this year or next year. And use it, and use him on the left false nine. Very high off the ball and good good finishing composure and only 18 years old. And a lot of this prefer moves, play 1-2, play shot, move into channel. I think this guy will be fantastic in this formation. Only problem, his determination is shit, so he needs to be tutored. Maybe by Casanova. I still didn't play any draw. All in. Every game I'm all in. Okay, this guy is back. Salah can go on the bench. If I have him, let's say, instead of Palombo, Kessié from Atalanta, and here Thiago Maia and Bruno Fernandes, right? Fuck it. Very good midfield. I need to buy also this fucking right back. There is that guy from Red Bull, tall guy. I like him. I think in this formation he will be good. Cassano is basically a man of the moment. He's like tourist on the field, and sometimes he can do something when you're not expecting. But if you want to see continuous work rate and performance from him, forget about that. So Napoli Juventus are playing. Currently is 1-1. Let's hope Napoli will defeat Juventus. Cassano. Look this fucking ball. This thing is driving me crazy. This is not possible in normal football. A lot of time I'm having this situation. Fuck. I'm giving chance again this sprite. But first half went very fast. First half, I mean. And it looks like this will be maybe draw, my first draw. I'm having that kind of feeling. Where are you fucking Cassano? He's nowhere. Time is going very fast. This will be draw. You will see. Where is this fucking Budimir? Can you do some header? Yeah, they are too expensive for me. Thiago Maia and Kessié. No, I don't want to bring midfielder. I'm only defensive midfielder, yes, instead of Palombo, but these two central midfielder, I'm having the players. I need one false nine, but then I need to put Cassano on bench, but I don't want to do that also. I would rather put Muriel on the bench. Can you cross? This was good build up, but fucking cross was shit. I lost the game, fuck. If he score, I lost the game. Napoli went 1-2, fuck. I need to go again attacking. All in. I put Dodo, so maybe he will have some chance to do some good offensive cross. But I think I lost this game. Sí, Kazan 6.5, Budimir 6.4, Muriel 6.2. Cannot win the game if all three strikers are very poor. I was thinking it will be 0-0, but on end I lost the game. Fucking shit. I need to do this team meeting. So I increase a little bit morale. Often comes this penalty. I even score the goals from this type of penalty. But never mind, this is this guy is having very low. Low work rate for midfielder. I have better options, so I want to sell him. So Atalanta away and then Inter Milan at home. This will be fucked up games. Good thing Napoli lost. My fullbacks are these two tall guys, not so bad, but I would like to buy better right back than this guy. I'm using this guy, but I need better guy with better positioning and on the left side I'm using this guy. Not so bad, not so good, let's say average. I need to buy a better central defender because this guy having concentration 9, I'm leaking stupid goals. I need better central defender also. So right back, one central defender, two. I need a good defensive midfielder to replace Palombo, the guy who can run more. And let's say some false 9, good one. I mean, there is a lot of space for improvement with this team. You can see fucking Juventus is winning everything and... The good thing, I'm still in the fighting for second place. I'm not behind, so... I can be even better and better, I'm hoping. I lost against Pescara and Atalanta is much better team. Can my team now perform? Where is this fucking Budimir? Last two games he was nowhere. Oh, fucking Palombo is Kevin Card. I need to replace him. I need to use Barreto then on his position. Tackle him there like that. So this type of approach I'm missing from Cassano. Direct run. Cross it, fuck it. Palermo is on bottom, and Milan also. I just hoping that Palombo will not receive second yellow card. I'm having some domination, but no goal. Budimir, I need your fucking goals if I want to keep the pace up. I need goal from my striker. I'm really dominating in this fucking game. That's why I'm really afraid, because I'm thinking from the first shot Atalanta will score the goal. having that kind of feeling. Maybe even now, look. Yeah, Budimir is missing chances. So two guys with yellow cards, I will replace them immediately. I will not put Pride in this game, I will put this another guy. This Torreira, he's more balanced player, I really like him, look his stats, very good all-around player. Yeah, all instruction, everything is doing assistant manager. Later on I'll show everything is doing assistant manager. Terry McDermott, my standard assistant manager. What the fuck? Don't give him now card for nothing. Shit! Now I need to replace this guy also. I'm having bad feeling with this fucking game. What he was trying to do this Muriel, fuck it. I need to get rid of him also. Fuck. Finally, fuck it. I Kassan a veteran fight. Kassan a one foul. Why are you going back? He can't even now even dribble. He's like American saying, all-star player. You see, when you have in this situation, why I like to have tall fullbacks. Every defensive header he is winning. So Poland cannot keep the ball when they are under pressure. Oh, Kasana. Very good ball, but Bodimir missed. Yeah, I cannot do any substitution because already all three I done. I mean, if I receive a red card, I will just... Oh. I was having a lot of shots, but... Very good positioning by Goldaniga. Positioning and concentration are really, really important for central defender. For me, even more important than, let's say, strength or... Oh, Kasana! So as you can see, I'm still on the second place somehow. Not playing so bad, but as you can see, I'm really lacking high quality in this team. If I'm having, let's say, Troy Deeney and Ighalo in this team, I will maybe won the league. I mean the strikers from Watford. Kasano is having high rating in this fucking game, 9.1. So next game is against Inter. So we will see how my defense will do against Icardi and Perisic. Let's hope Inter maybe sold Icardi, I'm not sure. So you see Kasana, 9.1 rating. Two assists, one goal. Will I go and try to buy Cookie? The problem with him is he's not so fast. Even if I bring him, I don't know how he will fit on this wide position. I would like that he has some work rate and so as you can see, this is a responsibility of my staff. You see? I don't do nothing. Everything is doing my Terry. Sampdoria Inter. So 11 games, 5 goals, 3 assists. Not so bad. Who is now sending me some messages? So Napoli lost some points, always good. Icardi is playing, but no Perisic, but this will be also, this Icardi is like Dybala, completely overrated player. Even in reality, I don't like him. I feel that he's so, he is very dependent of his team. So I'm having some suspension of my players. I will give Pride start. So I'm missing Bruno Fernandes. Fuck. Very important player. So Dodo is against Kandreva, also very bad situation for my team. Because Kandreva is typical winger, I mean wide player, who do a lot of crosses, and Dodo is very poor defensively. He tried to lob goalkeeper in this situation. Why yellow card? Fucking immediately. On defensive midfielder, yellow card. I hate this kind of situation. Now I need until half time. Need to survive until half time. He's my captain also. Kasan. Juventus only received 4 goals, fuck. 30 score, 4 received. A really high domination. This Muriel is having a lot of this kind of situation, but he can't score a goal. He didn't score any goal outside. How many times he shoot? That's why it's important to have on wide area a guy who has very high long shot, plus finishing and composure. So now situation is even more bad because I need to put Cigarini here and Torreira there. Now I'll be much weaker. How is this guy? I'm having one youngster. Will I risk in this game? No chance to go attacking against Icardi. One direct ball and I'm fucked. Why you didn't try to pass on the other side? Cassano was there alone. Very good ball. Very good reaction from keeper. This is I like to have this type of keeper who can catch these fucking crosses. Will I be happy with draw? I think I will be happy with draw. I don't want to lose only so. Can he score the fucking goal? This is situation what when I need good striker. Give me fucking penalty there. 5.9 rating of striker. I can do one substitution more. No. I will put this Juricic, even Morales shit. I mean, I was having some chances, but no finishing. No quality in attacking. No attacking quality in the team. You see how many fucking hours this guy didn't. 9 hours he didn't score the fucking goal. 9 hours! I think I will do this one more game. Striker, 9 hours, no goal. And I'm still by result, I'm doing good, but. Yeah, I will need to buy a striker in January. So guys, when you picking the club, try always to pick the club who has very good strikers, and then or striker, then the job is much easier. If you have striker who can score 25-30 goals, everything else is much easier. Ah, fuck. So Cassano is also off for 3 weeks. Will I use Juricic now? Most probably I will need to use him. Even if he is having poor morale. I also lost, see, Silvestre. Nothing, Dodo will play on as left back and Regini as central defender, and that's it. This fucking stuff bullshitting. So Bologna away, Roma at home. We will see how he will play now on the right side. I will put him on the right side and Juricic will go on the left. Morale is shit, but Bruno Fernandes is back. Nah. This is a situation when he needs to score from this type of situations. Must be offside. This fucking Lazio is pushing hard, look. He already fucking 6 points advantage. I'm replacing this guy. Both of them. Just put him in and immediately yellow card. Why not pass? He was in. He was running with full speed. So he's. He want to score header from 15 meters. Very interesting choice. I will replace Barreto with Bright. Pass him. I think I'll draw again. I started to losing the points. What the fuck? Almost out of goal. Yeah, Muriel will score goal next year, probably. And he reached 20 hours without no goal. Ask him. So Pride again. I already done all three, so can do nothing. I'm already defensive. So always when you buy midfielder, try to buy midfielder who can score from the range. So long shot always is welcomed. Okay. I would say this will be very, very important 3 points, especially because Lazio is fucking playing quite good in division. A lot of points for Lazio, and they defeated me. Very, very big win for my side. Roma lost against Torino, and now they are playing against me. So guys, that will be all for today. I think I play more than fucking 2 hours. I mean, I'm having good results, but the general feeling, I'm not happy. I'm basically lacking the quality of the strikers. If I have that, for sure I will fight for the title. But reality is another thing. But we will see, maybe on the January transfer window I can do something. As you can see, I'm having now striker with 10 hours. He didn't score the goal, fuck. So next game is Roma home, then some cup, and then Torino home. So my schedule in the first half, I play a lot of, let's say, bigger games I get at home. So second half of season will be very, very fucked up. Motherfucking president. President is fucking me. Now when I want to fucking sell half of the team. Like always, before I save, I will just check my lineup. Fucking morale is shit. So that's it for today. So if you have some suggestions, just post in Twitch chat or on my YouTube channel. Probably tomorrow I will upload this episode, maybe even tonight. Yeah, it was really interesting, but the results are good, but as I said, feeling not so good. So, see you guys tomorrow.